that many of you already have this catalog in your possession, or you were able to view it today online. I know I say this every single year. Maybe not. I'd like to think that I didn't say it last year, but I really mean it. This is one of the most exciting catalogs, I think, in a while. I mean, I always love the holiday catalogs, but as far as big main catalogs, I love it. Love it, love it, love it. So we're going to go through it really fast, and if we have time, we're going to make a project at the end. It'll be a simple project, but we'll try to fit it in. I didn't mean to start 10 minutes late, so sorry about that. And I won't talk about all this stuff because most of you that are here are not new to stamping, so you're already familiar with wood mount, clear mount, the color collections and all of that. But if you have any questions, feel free to definitely post it in the chat box, okay? Jason, you're right. And the site was slow this afternoon. In fact, it didn't even work at all. But this morning, even I think I placed my order at, I started it at 6:30, and I'm embarrassed to say that it took me like an hour and a half because I kept trying to weed things out, and then every time I would try to take something out, I'd have to put it back in because I'm like, oh, but what if I need it? Anyway, so you're going to see lots of check marks because I did order a bit more than I should have, but what can I say? I love it. So we're going to go ahead and swing through. And I'm just going to kind of point out the pages that are really cute to me. I absolutely love this page. And it features the Cherry on Top Designer Series paper stack. I already have 6 projects created using that little paper pack. And I'm calling it my teeny tiny, what is it? Cherry on Top Teeny Tiny Treats class. Anyway, it's a bunch of projects I'm posting on Chicken Click. But I love that paper. It's beautiful colors. And it's not just the in colors. In fact, I think only 2 of the new in colors are in there. But it's just the combination of colors. Okay, so these 2 sides are carryover. So, wait, can you guys see the catalog okay? Do I need to zoom out or turn on any extra lights? So you can type into the chat box if I need to zoom out. Just type zoom out or turn on some more lights, which I just realized one light was not on. Okay, I'll keep looking up. I'll proceed, and if you guys tell me to zoom out, I will. This page here, again, the samples are stinking cute. And sprinkles on top. I did order that stamp set because how could I not? Yeah, it's so cute. On this page here, this one is new. Birthday Blossoms. I do like it, and I will at some point probably order it just because, I mean, I have a lot of flowers, but I love this little cluster of flowers. I love the Happy Birthday, but I really like this right here because you can stamp this twice and then cut this one out and pop it up with a dimensional, and then, of course, this one works with a punch, the Pansy Punch. So anything that has a punch, okay, more light. I hear you. I will turn on some more lights and zoom out a little. Let's see. Whoops, that was zooming in. How about that? Oh, I think that's much better. But let me know if I need to zoom in. And then, let's see. My light. One more light I can turn on. Okay, that one didn't have a plug, so that one will not be getting it. Okay, sorry about that. Hopefully that's better. Great, I love the word perfect. Okay, so again, I did not order that yet. but I probably will at some point. This one's a repeat. This one I ordered, and the reason I ordered it, don't laugh, but most of you already know me. I ordered it because this image here works with the framelits, and then Yay will fit in a punch. The cake will fit in a punch, and the HB will fit in a punch. So I ordered it because I can see myself stamping that and putting it on a punch, and then at the bottom using a stamp that says happy birthday. Anyway, both of these are repeats, and this one is one of our pre-order sets, and I did make something. I think what I did was I kind of recreated this right here when I was fiddling with my Hawaii swaps. I didn't use it because it was too time consuming, but I do like it, and I will be using that one. This is a carryover from the Occasions catalog. I love this. I love all the samples. I did order this one. This one's called Endless Thanks. I love all stamp sets that have to do with thank you, because that is pretty much the one card that I do send are thank you cards. And I like the change in the font. So there's the pretty script font, and then there's the little typed font. So you can see my little check mark here. And then, I don't know why I'm moving this, because I don't really don't have to. It's all in the view. Right here, a world of thanks. That's a background stamp. And I ordered it because this sample right here is so pretty. It makes a really quick card. The next page, again, I'm moving this. I'm going to stop. Is One Big Meaning. And I ordered it because this thank you will fit in a punch. And I love, love, love this little, a little thanks. That's just going to be so sweet on a card or a little box. And then, of course, I did look at the samples. So if you look at the projects on the pages and you see this thank you from all of us, that's really awesome, too. It's a little big, but I like it. Oh, there I go again, moving it again. Me equals grateful. I ordered that one. Again, this one right here fits in a punch. And I think this one will fit in the 2.5-inch circle. Anyway, and the yum, that will fit in the 2.5-inch circle. Okay, Lisa, what are you saying that you didn't look well at? I think maybe my chat box is not moving up. Both of these are carryover. Okay, so this one right here, either I'm losing my mind, which is very likely. If this one doesn't say new, I don't remember it being. It's possible it's a carryover. I just don't remember it. Because this whole Born to be Loved and You Make My Heart Go Boom Boom, that's hilarious. Anyway, it says, it doesn't say it's new, but it's the first time I noticed it. I didn't order it because we're going into the holiday, to Christmas, Thanksgiving, Halloween, but I'll probably get it when we get closer to Valentine's. Do I have a template for my punches? You know, I do. I bought it from Stampin' Up! Years ago, but I kind of hid it because every time I bring that thing out, people want to know how to get one, so I just get out my punch. But yeah, I used to have a cute little, okay, so if you take a binder ring, yeah, and you cut your cardstock, so what I did, we'll pretend. I'm going to show you how I used to have them. I don't know where they are. You tend to do things resurface. So this is the size of what I had for my punches, Jason. And what I would do is I'd have a hole punch right here in the corner. And then this is where the punch would be. And then I'd have a little label and it would say heart punch or circle punch or whatever. I don't use them anymore because everything I do is online now. I don't have a local, I don't do anything in person. So, yeah. I just carried on. Hopefully, I didn't carry on for too long. I start to rattle. Okay, this set right here, Over the Rainbow, it's cute. I didn't order it yet. It is on my wish list, but I couldn't think of, like, I read every one of these, and I couldn't justify getting it because I can't use it like this month or next month because none of these phrases, I wouldn't use them right now. So if the occasion arises, I will. I wanted to really order it for this and these little splotches, but I didn't. Something probably at convention will prompt me to order it. This is a carryover. This is a carryover, and this is really awesome. I didn't order it yet. It's kind of big, but maybe that's good. But I don't send out very many Get Well Soon cards myself. I should, but I don't. But look how cute this is. Look at this sample. Oh, I just love it. Okay, moving on. What time is it? Okay, we're not running late or anything. Oh yeah, Susan baseball sleeve covers. I've seen that before a long time ago, like really a long time ago. Okay, both of these sets are carryover. This is a carryover. Carryover. This one's new. I didn't order it. It is very pretty. This one's a carryover from the, it's almost like I need to tape this thing down so I don't move it. this is from the Occasions catalog. This one's new. Carryover. Carryover. Okay, see my little star here? Of course I ordered this. I love the little animals. They're so cute. How can you not love them? And I'm happy that you don't have to stamp, like the greetings are separate from the animals. So I can take this little goat here and say happy birthday instead of whatever, however you say that. But I like this little cow and he's going to fit perfectly in a punch. That's what's most exciting about these is that I think every one of these will fit in a punch. Yeah, I know they will. Okay, I'm going to look for questions really quick. Okay, I don't think I see any. Okay, so this set here, I did not order yet. I really like the font, but I already have a couple, and I'm not using Project Life right now. I just don't have enough time. I want to really bad, and I keep saying I'm going to. So I'm finally going to stop saying I'm going to. I'm just going to say, you know, when I start having grandkids or when we start taking a lot of pictures, I'll start right now. Man, my pictures consist of Skittles and Bella. And I'm not sure how many scrapbook pages I could do of the bird and the dog. Anyway, so this stamp set, All God's Grace, I totally ordered it. And I ordered it for the cross and the bird. Yeah, I did, because I don't know anyone, having a baptism or a christening or a confirmation. Everyone I know has already been through all of that, but if you look at this card right here, and you look at this one right here, it's so cute. I love it, and you could use that with something other than baptism and christening, yeah. Okay, so here's another set I really wanted to order. I'm going to stop moving this. But I didn't because I don't know anyone having babies right now. And I wanted to order it for these little background stamps and for the word thanks. But I didn't because I don't know anyone having babies. Okay, whoops. Next one. I did order this one, and I ordered it just for the animals. Y'all are going to think that I'm completely off my rocker, but This little kitty cat is so cute. And the bunny and the little deer and the bird. And look, I love this. It says made with love. Congrats. I love the font too. All of them. So I probably won't use these because, again, we don't have a baby. But I can use this for other stuff. That little kitty cat could say happy birthday. And Easter. Yes, Easter. Oh, I love it. I never figured out if the perfect baby, if that greeting was attached to the cat. Because if it is, I'm just going to cut it off. I don't know. I didn't do the math. There's 20 stamps, but I'll figure it out. And if it is attached, then I'm just going to separate it with my hot knife. Yeah. This is a carryover. Okay, this right here. I don't know if you guys saw this when you looked through this catalog. And I wish I had the pictures with me. They're still on my phone. Ugh. Hence the reason why I'm not scrapbooking. It's this little background, it's not little. This is a full-size background stamp. It's called Writing Notes. Pam used this on some cards in Hawaii. Oh my gosh, it was so stinking cute. I totally had to order it. In fact, I could not wait to order that. And I would not have ordered it had I not seen those samples. I need to find those pictures. Words of Truth. I want that one. I think it's on the top of my wish list for next time. Yeah, Words of Truth, page 41. I just couldn't. I just had to draw the line somewhere. So it's on my list. And I kept looking at this and I'm like, oh, I'm going to be kicking myself that I didn't get it. But because this right here, I love you more than grilled cheese. Chase loves grilled cheese sandwiches, especially my sister's secret concoction of stuff that she makes her special grilled cheese sandwiches. So I'd love to make something with that for him. Okay, that's a repeat, which I'm glad that's still around. I love this set, but I didn't order it. Chase and Brooke were so totally into dinosaurs when they were little. And now with Jurassic Park coming back on June 12th, and that Triceratops would fit inside of a Circle Punch, I'm sure. But yeah, I didn't get it because I don't have little kids right now. Yeah, Susan, I'm gonna find those pictures, I swear, and I'm gonna get them posted because that little set of cards alone, and she didn't write on those. She didn't write on it at all. It just was just decor of the card. It was really cool. You know what? I'm going to write that down on my wish list so that I don't forget. Post pictures of Pam's cards. That's all I need because those cards were so stinking cute. Okay. I did order Skating By because it just reminds me of Chase. Because he used to have a skateboard. He had a guitar. We have this little thing, which I don't even know what it's called. I have no clue what that is. I want to say it's a name tag or an iPod or I don't know. And can I just say that right there a little bit freaks me out. I'm not real sure what's going on with that hand there. I guess you could, I don't know. Y'all look at that page and tell me what you're thinking. There's a hand in the middle of the page, but then there's a line through this one. So I think his hand is supposed to hold this and hold this and hold this, and I don't know, but it looks strange. I ordered it though, because that's one I could use with Chase. And I ordered Hey Girl because even though this dog is probably, or it is, a schnauzer, and Bella isn't, it's still so stinking cute, and I'll use it for something. And I like the hey girl, and I like the girl, and the shopping. I love it all. And then this one is almost, I would have to say that this one just might be my most favorite set next to the ones in the Christmas section. I love it. And I will probably get two of them because I know that I'm going to cut off that have a snappy day and probably insert a happy birthday. I don't know if you guys looked at this set. This is the kind of images I really love, but the crab has eyelashes, which I guess technically we could call her a girl. I love it. Love it, love it, love it. I love the frog. Okay, so moving on. Repeats. Repeats. I didn't order that one, but I have to tell you, look, oh, it's a Scotty dog, not a Schnauzer. You're probably right. I don't know my dogs. So what's the difference, I wonder? I think all them little dogs sometimes look a Scotty. I'm never going to remember that. Is it really a Scotty dog? Oh, if you don't want him to hold something. So then you have to stamp that over that, though. Oh, they're photopolymer, so you can just slap it right on. Well, yeah. It is a Scotty dog. Dang, how would you know? I'm glad y'all told me, because I would have swore that was a Schnauzer. Is it because of his beard? Okay, I'm moving on. Y'all can tell me later. Already have this set. Already have this set. I think I got this one in Hawaii, though. I don't think I bought that one. No, I got this one in Hawaii. Well, how did I get that one? Maybe I didn't. Oh, you have a Schnauzer. That's how you know. Thanks, Kara. You know what I'm going to do? I'm actually going to go back to that page really quick, and I'm going to write that it's a Scotty. Just in case I forget. Okay, so up here we're on page 56. Oh, I spelled it wrong. Oh, goodness gracious. That's okay. I'll fix it later. I'll Google it. I'll get some white out and fix it. Stamp a bag. Of course I ordered that, because if you look at the samples, you have to have it. I'm totally going to be using that for Halloween and Christmas. Yeah, I don't have a Scotty dog, so if I had one, I'd know how to spell it. Because I know how to spell a cabochon. Okay, so this set right here, oh my gosh, I love it. And I loved it when I saw it, and then when I got it in, I was like, I don't know what I'm going to do with it. But then when I started making samples, several of my Tiny Treats Projects is using this right here. I love this set. So if you guys pre-ordered it, if you were available, if you were able to, it's awesome. I have not used this one yet, though, but I will. Okay, these are repeats. I did order this, and it is because I looked again at the samples. Although I would have ordered it anyway, because this fits in a circle punch, and so does this. But I love the dots, and I'm not sure I'll use that. Maybe so, but I love these three, so I got it. Carry over. This one I got in Hawaii, and there's a little story about this one. I'll make it really, really, really quick. I didn't go to one of the programs in Hawaii because I have a hard time getting on the buses and getting off, just being around a lot of people. And it was, I just couldn't go to everything. And they gave away a free stamp set that day, and I didn't get it. And of course, I was sick. But anyway, long story short, one of the ladies didn't want her photopolymer set, and she turned it in and said they could give it to someone. And I walked up and said, is there any chance I can have that stamp set? And they're like, oh, we have an extra one right here. So I got it. Yay! I haven't used it yet. But, oh yes, I did. Take it back. I used this one right here, and this one right here for my Tiny Treats class, because this fits perfectly in that 1-inch square punch that I am bound and determined to keep in our catalog. So I'm going to use that punch every week this year to make sure that it doesn't retire next year. And then this one uses, I think, if I'm not mistaken, yeah, it does. It uses the new washi label punch, which I will have soon. That's a repeat. Okay, I got this one because, oh my gosh, this is so cute. I ordered this all boxed up kit. The kits in here are so awesome. So, of course, I ordered this kit. Hey, look, that's just created by Angie. Huh. It wasn't me, but... woohoo for you. Sending happy thoughts your way. That's really nice. Wishing you the very best. What does this say this coordinates with? The 1 3/4 circle punch. So that's why I ordered it. This is a carryover. I ordered this one and I still don't... I went back and forth and back and forth because... I don't know anyone getting married, and I don't know anyone having a baby, and I don't know anyone moving, but I really do like this thanks to you, and I like this thing here. So I got it, because I'm anticipating that something Christmassy or something Halloween is going to fit in there, and I'd be kicking myself if I didn't have it. I should have put it on my wait list instead of ordering it today, but I ordered it today. And this one, Stake Your Claim. Oh my gosh. I love it. And it goes with the hand-picked framelits, which I just finally used this week on Chicken Click. But I never did use it on Chicken Scratch, so I'm sorry. I just couldn't. Oh, I love the 1.5-inch circle punch. I'm so excited about that one, too. Sorry, lane swerve there. He wrote it. Jason's responsible. Okay, so Sweet Stack. This fits in a circle. So I got it. And then I like this. I think that goes in a framelit, right? A thinlet. The Cutie Pie thinlet. And then this, I don't know. It just looks so cute. I ordered it. Now, I'm so excited that there's Christmas in here. In fact, I'm on a mission to make sure that Christmas stays in the annual catalog forever. So I ordered all the Christmas stuff, and I even ordered more than one pack of paper because I want to make sure that it sells well enough to justify them having it back in the catalog. So I ordered this stamp set, and I am absolutely going to do a Christmas project or two or three or four or five in the month of July. I probably won't do it in June because some people might think I'm off my rocker, but I have definitely done Christmas in July. In fact, I did that last year on Chicken Click. So the reindeer, super cute. Love it. I anticipate that I'll be using him for my reindeer food unless we get another reindeer in the holiday catalog. And I ordered this one because, oh my gosh, look at these tags. They're so stinking cute. I love it. I'm already ready for Christmas projects, but I'm not ready for Christmas weather. Yeah. That was a carryover. No, it's not. I swear it looks like a carryover, but it says it's new. So maybe it's not a carryover. Yeah, it's not. It's new. There's something different about this. Carryover. So we have one single Halloween image right there. Carryover. That was the biggest seller out of the holiday catalog was that thing. This one is cute. I think I might. Do I have it on my wish list? I don't. I do have this one on my wish list, though. I just couldn't justify getting all of them. So this, I didn't get this or the framelits. There is a bundle that you save 15%. So I will get that at some point, probably when I earn some Hostess dollars. I always order clear, Kim. The wood just takes up way too much space. And yeah. And you know, taking the, because it's just me, myself, and I in here, it's really not a problem. I don't, you know, I don't have to share my stamps with anyone. I don't really lose them. They don't get thrown in the trash. I know when I had that retreat last year, it was a little challenging. So if people have, you know, face-to-face businesses or stamp camps or that kind of thing, I get why some people love the wood, but I'm all clear. Okay, so for the people that loved the Christmas version, now we have the Circle of Spring. I love the font of all of these. The thank you, happy Easter, happy birthday to you. Oh, I love it, love it, love it. So I ordered it. And yeah, happy Easter. Easter's already gone, but next year, these are all repeats. This is pretty. I like it. Especially looking at the samples. I didn't order it yet, but I really do like that. But I can't use it in a punch, either one of those. But you could use it with the new triple banner, triple punch. this right here, everybody wants to order it, to like today. We can't. It's available in July, so that just gives us something to look forward to in July. Everybody that I've talked to wants to order this card kit. I think it's going to be one of those that just sells like, what's the word? Hotcakes. Yeah. So July. I don't think they've given us a date. Okay, so this one I did order. Gift from the Garden. I didn't really have a reason. That would fit in a punch, although I'm not sure it would look all that great. I like gardeny stuff, so I ordered it. Repeats. This one's new. Yeah, I like it. Especially because we went deep sea fishing and we saw sea turtles, but I don't, that's not really my style. I think I have this one. That's a repeat. That's a carryover. This is a carryover. Oh, that's new. I swear, when you've been around a while, some of these animal sets will start to look similar. That dog doesn't look, but this dude or whatever that thing is. Carryover. This stamp set right here is older than I am. What will it be? 13 years in October for me. And it's been in the catalog ever since I've been a demonstrator. Carryover, which I'm happy. I love that set for fall. This one's new. Carryover from the occasions. Carryover, carryover, carryover. Carryover, carryover. Oh, this one's really cute. Yep, so I ordered it. And the kit. Because I like the fonts, and I can see myself saying all of these. Carryover, carryover. That I got during the pre-order. I did not order this one yet, but I will tell you, if you look at this, you look at this card right here, and then this one, and it's like, oh man, I should have ordered that. It says, "You're on my mind, but not in a creepy way." I love that. But I can wait. I don't need it today. Oh, let's see. I'm looking at the questions. Okay. Two F blocks. Mount one. And then place the card stack on. Oh, yeah. I do that. Yeah. Okay. This is a repeat from the Occasions catalog. And thank goodness, because I bought it. No, I didn't buy it. I got it for free, and I never used it. And Father's Day is coming up, so I'm gonna use it here pretty soon. Repeat, repeat, repeat. It's Wild is a new one. I didn't order it. I have to see a sample before I get sold on that one, to be honest. But this card right here is stinking cute. And I think I already have that one, but I just haven't used it in forever. This is a repeat, which I'm glad, because that was a good set in the Occasions catalog. I ordered this one, Happy Happenings. Thank you again. All of these will fit. Today's the day. Congrats. Happy birthday. Yeah, I can see myself saying the majority of these greetings. Repeats, repeats, repeat, repeat. All of these are repeats. I did order this. Oh, okay. So this is another thing that everybody's ordering, is the 10 of Cards project kit and the stamp set. I am so totally going to film a video and get this posted. Totally. I'm not going to let this thing sit in the box over there like I have some of the other ones. I'm going to do it. Even if somebody else has already done, which I think probably Stampin' Up! Is probably going to have a video of this, but I'm going to have my own. Okay, let me see. There's a question here. Lisa, I have asked them to sell individual stamps in a series. I'm going to keep asking. But, I mean, I don't want all of our stamps to be sold as single. I just have this I have this idea of a line that we could carry that we could sell single stamps. Because I agree with you. Sometimes the greetings is not a greeting that I would use. Anyway, we'll keep hoping. Gail says on page 105, let me go to 105. The card with the bag. 105. The card with the bag. Is that a bag? Yeah, that's a bag. Can I make that for a demo? Well, let me write it down and let me see if I can. I will try. Page 105. Can I demo that card? Okay, I wrote it down. Ooh, look how beautiful this card is. There's a lot of really beautiful samples in here. And look at this page here. It's so pretty. But I did not order that stamp set. I didn't order this one. I can tell you it is on my wish list. I went back and forth and back and forth. And the only reason I didn't order it today is because I had already ordered this one. This one was one of the pre-orders. And I used this one on my swap card for Hawaii. But I don't know. There's something about this. I think it's because when I joined in 2002, a lot of our stamps had this type of a sketched line to it. And it's just, I just love it. Love it, love it. Oh, let's see. How do you... Oh, so Gail, what are you asking? How do you make... Oh, how do you make the bag? Is that what you're asking? Or how to make the card? All of this page is repeats. And this is a repeat, but this is that stamp set that has these really beautiful samples right here. I didn't order it because, to be honest, you guys know I'm kind of a lazy stamper and I wouldn't color that much. In fact, yeah, I wouldn't. I'll be honest. So I love it. And we saw some samples in Hawaii and they were amazing. And I was really intimidated. yeah, so maybe one day, but not for me. I did order this one. Did I order it? I thought I had it on my wish list. No, that was the wings. I got it because it just reminds me of when I joined. And I liked the samples. So, remember when I was telling you guys how Pam made her card using the background, the lined background? Here's the card right here using that background. I know, Karen. I don't even want to go down that road. These are pretty big, though, so hopefully I will use it. Both of these are repeats. And this one I ordered because I saw one card that I loved. And that's what we do sometimes. I have a ton of flower sets, but there's just something about this set that is so pretty. So hopefully I'll make a card and y'all will understand why. Plus the butterfly is really pretty. It's a different, I always like the little, the watercolor look. This one is new. I don't know. These are both repeats. This one I love, and I didn't mark it because that was a pre-order. And I have used this You're the Best with this little swirly thing right here a ton. In fact, I think I used that on my, I used it on my Bohemian Top Note bag that I posted yesterday. Yeah, the bee is stinking cute, isn't it? I love this set. Both of these are repeats. Thank goodness this stayed. I'm so thrilled that this one is in here because I do love this set. And I also use that. I use this with a combination of a Hostess set on my swap card. And I ordered this one because I love dragonflies and fairies. Not that there's a fairy in here, but there is a dragonfly. And I like this little image and this image and this image and this image. Yeah, I looked at the sample up here, looked at this page, and I love how this is all stamped. Repeat, repeat. I ordered the brush strokes because of the sample. So I looked at this right here. Let's hope I use it. I could see myself saying, ugh, that's a lot of work. But if you read the tip right here, it says, ink the large background in multiple colors with sponge daubers. I can do that. Back in the old days, we used to have those spectrum pads. Anyway, so I got that background stamp. I got the Dots for Days background stamp. I got the watercolor wash. Again, I looked at this sample right here, and I'm like, whew, I gotta have that. And if you look at the sample here, well, you gotta have that one too. So I didn't order this one, but the rest of the new ones I did. This one was a pre-order, so I got that. And I don't know if you guys know this, but this high, let me make sure I'm not losing my mind. Yeah. I don't know. Maybe I am losing my mind. Let me look. What does that go with? It actually goes with, coordinates with the Circle Collection framelits. Well, maybe this high doesn't go with anything. Jason, help. Are you still on here? That doesn't work on the cloud. Well, then how do you cut that cloud out? Did they freehand it? I was thinking you could use it with this punch, but you can't. It doesn't work on the Tree Builder punch. It works with other framelits, I wonder. Let me fast forward to the framelits page, because for some reason, I kept thinking that there was a framelit that would cut that out. But maybe it isn't. There isn't. I guess not. Oh, well. I still have it. I like it. Oh, it retired. Okay. This is a repeat from the Occasions catalog. This, all of these are repeats. Yeah, because that's, I use this on my journal. Repeat. This is not a repeat. This is new. That was in the pre-order, I think. I don't know. I gotta check. I'm going to skip past this page because I can't remember if I have that one or not. This is a repeat. Look how cute this is. They put the sequin on a little clothespin. One of them old-timey things. I have some little bowls like this. Okay, so the end colors. Most of you have probably already seen all the in colors, but I'll get them out really quick to show you. So, Cucumber Crush, Delightful Dijon, Mint Macaron, and Tip Top Taupe, and Watermelon Wonder. And I'm going to call that everything. I'm just going to call it Watermelon, because for whatever reason, I can't remember the Wonder. I think I want to call it, like, I don't know what I want to call it, but that Wonder word escapes me. This one reminds me of pistachio pudding. So for those of you that were going to miss that color, that almost replaces it, especially if you look at the cardstock. It's a little blue. Yeah, so here's the cardstock. Somebody just opened our front door. I wonder who. Oh, I wanted to show y'all a little tip I did today. This just came to me. So I have an organizer that holds all my ink refills and ink pads and all of that. And so today, I took the cupcake punch and I punched out one of those little teeny tiny circles. And I just took my liquid glue and just put just a drop of liquid glue and added that little circle. So now when I look, I like it. And then the other thing that I did today is when you get your ink pads, you have all these extra labels in a language that you can't pronounce. So what I did was I peeled it off and I cut it apart. And then I just attached it on the inside. So that way, if you've got several ink pads open, you'll know what color it is. Because you really can't even tell. If you're looking at those side by side, you would not know which one was Mint Macaron, and Cucumber Crush. So now you can. I used to do that in the old days. I used to label everything when I had Stamp Club. But now when it's just me, myself, and I in here. But it is nice. Okay, what are y'all talking about? Let's see. Can you get them separate? Which kit? Yeah, which kit are you asking about? Thank you. Which kit are y'all asking about? Okay, whenever we get to the kit thing, what I'm going to do is just keep flipping because we're getting to the back of the book. And I want to make, I have used the word window punch before a long time ago, but this is free because it's on the bottom. And I don't have to do much. Okay, so designer series paper. So for those of you that usually print my designer series paper charts, as soon as I get the paper in, I will create those charts and get them posted on my blog and on Chicken Click. I ordered all of the papers today. So we've got Color Me, Irresistible, Specialty, blah, 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 blah. Typeset is a repeat. And then we've got Everyday Chick, Bohemian, English Garden, Farmer's Market, Sweet Little Things, Merry Moments, I ordered three of that one, Timeless Elegance, and Schoolhouse Designer. And if you haven't noticed, we have the coordinating cardstock now to go with the paper pack. So I didn't order all of them because I already own all the paper, but I did order one pack to match the English Garden just so I could see it and show everybody. So I ordered one, just one of those. I think that's great for all of our customers to see the coordinating paper. We've got Go Wild Designer Series Paper Stack, Cherry on Top, Pretty Petals, which I already told you guys, I absolutely love the Cherry on Top. And then we have all of our In Color collections, which I totally love. There are two of them right now that you can't order. The sizing was a little off, so the Regals and the neutrals were an eighth of an inch off, and they've been pulled right now. So as soon as they're available, I'll post that on my website. Yeah, I think I'm going to love the English Garden. It looks like it's right up my alley. Until I actually get the paper in my hand, I'm not sure. I think I'm going to like several of them because I like softer colors. And I see some pool party in this one. I don't know if that's Calypso Coral. Yeah, that may be, I don't know. I have to see it. The Christmas one, well, I like the cherry on top for sure. So that's going to hold me for sure. Now, all of this page I did not order because I ordered every single one of them in the last catalog. And I have not used but one of them. So maybe, hopefully. On this page, I ordered the glassine sheets so that I can make those cute little bags. We used to carry those bags in the old days. I ordered this new paper just so I could see what exactly it is. I ordered the cotton paper assortment. Everything that was new, the metallic doilies I ordered. The envelope paper, I used that on my Hawaii card, so you guys have seen that already if you saw my video. And then, yeehaw, the paper. I'm so excited for the 100-pound Whisper White cardstock. Ugh, I've been asking for that for years and years and years. So I'm super excited about that. Someone did, actually several people have asked, why do we have two? And the reason is because our Whisper White cardstock is absolutely perfect for stamping. It is the best cardstock for stamping. But it's not the perfect cardstock for everything. So you're going to find that having this thicker cardstock, it's going to be awesome. Take my word for it. I'll be showing you. Okay, so gift bag punch board. I already showed a video on that project or on that product. I love it, love it, love it. I love all of those. So tag-a-bag accessory, always love those. Ordered that. Craft tag-a-bag. I'm happy to see that's coming back. And that now we can stamp on it. Although I have to admit that I loved the chevron ones. But anyway. And then I got the sketched dots. This is going to be so awesome for Christmas, I think. I never really know until I actually make them. Everything else is a repeat. I did not order that kit because I'm not sure that I would assemble it, to be honest with you. 10 of cards I ordered. This is a carryover. This is a carryover. I will get that. I didn't yet, but I did order this because, of course, it's a box. I'm all over the boxes. Build a banner. I got that. This one's coming in July. This was the same kit that was back further in the catalog. So they're just repeating it in the kit section. And yeehaw, tear and tape adhesive. Oh, I'm so happy because sticky strip always hated me. I tried very hard to make it work and I never could. So I love this stuff. Decorative mask. I got the Happy Patterns, and I have all the new washi tape, Cherry on Top, the In Color, Bohemian, Everyday Chick. I think I may have forgotten to order the Sweet Little Things, which is okay. And then ribbon, huh, yeah. So we have the new Smoky Slate of the Chevron, and then we have thick baker's twine. All of those are new. We have silver and blushing bride sequin trim. I ordered the silver. I didn't get the blushing bride. I think I'm going to kick myself for not getting that one. Metallic thread. I ordered it in silver, but not gold. And then, let's see. I ordered the white, the Whisper White stitch satin ribbon. It doesn't say new on here, and I could not for the life of me remember if this was a carryover. Yeah. So the 5/8 inch striped cotton ribbon. All of these are new. Blackberry Bliss, Hello Honey, Lost Lagoon, Mossy Meadow, Tangelo Twist. So those are the in colors for last year. Oh, I should be looking at the chat box. Sorry. I got a little involved in looking at the pages. Diane, are you asking me what my favorite in colors are? If you're asking me, I would say those three are my favorite. Yeah, those three are my favorite of the new ones. But I have found myself using this one a ton because it goes with that bohemian paper. So, yes, Karen, I can if you'd like me to. I could not figure out, though, how to get that catalog cut. We'll talk about it in a couple minutes. I'll zip through this really, really quickly. Okay, so metallic sequin, these, I got those. The bright sequins, I got those. The blossom accents. The white perfect accents. So those to me look like candy dots, but they're white. I don't know. I can't wait to see them. And then the metal rimmed pearls. These are so beautiful. I think I'm going to love them. And they're really affordable. No new things on this page, I don't think. Okay, punches. So the 1.5 inch circle punch. Love it. Ordered it today. The new banner. I'm just going to call it the triple banner punch, but it's really the banner triple punch. These two are the only new on this page. And then the medium star is new. I got ordered that. The washi label is new. I ordered that. So hopefully this will make up for not having the modern label. And then the tree builder stamp set that goes with the Sprinkles of Life stamp set, which is so stinking cute. I love it. Yes, Susan, I am going to make a shaker card. I haven't made one in umpteen years. Like, seriously, I think the last time I made a shaker card was probably 2009. It's been forever. And when I was in Hawaii, I met Louise, and her swap card was a shaker card. And I'm like, man, I haven't made one in forever. So I'm going to make one. But unfortunately, our shaker things retired. But that's okay. We can use the edges of dimensionals again. We can go back to the old way. Questions. I'm pretty sure, Mary, that my UPS guy absolutely hates me. Between Stampin' Up! And Amazon Prime, I'm sure he curses me every day. yeah. The blendabilities, we had quality issues. That's a whole other subject. But they are trying to find a new distributor or a new company. So they do know there is a demand for those, or we loved them and they were doing very well, but there were issues with some of them, so they pulled them. And if you want me, if you want to call me, we can talk about it. Okay. Nothing new on this page. Now this one, yeehaw. The Cutie Pie Thinlets, which is just the little pie box, which is so cute. The Baker's Box Thinlet. Ordered that. I can't wait to get this one. Can't wait to use it. The rest of these are carryover. I didn't get the new butterfly because I already have this one, but this one goes with that other stamp set. I'll get it. I just didn't get it yet. I didn't get the new greeting thinlets yet either, but I want them. What else is new? I did get the lots of labels, and I did get the tags and labels. So these two are new, and I did order those. Sorry, guys. I think my daughter forgot I was doing a live stream. That was Brooke's ringtone. It's like, sounds like Flintstones, doesn't it? Elegant Dots embossing folder is the only new one I ordered. I think there's there's the Brick Wall, the Boho Chic, or Chic, I'm not sure, and Fluttering. I only ordered the Elegant. Well, I think I have this one because that was a pre-order, but I didn't order the other two yet, but I'm sure that I will. There are no new dies, sadly. And then everything's a repeat. Okay, so Hostess stamp sets. I have stopped using the Hostess stamp sets because every now and then when I would use them, someone would say that they never had a chance to get them. So this is my plug-in for my Stamp Club Online and my Hostess Code Club. If you are not ever able to earn Hostess benefits, I have two clubs that you can join, and everyone places a minimum order of $25 a month, and they take turns being Hostess, and you can earn these sets. So happy birthday, everyone. A whole lot of lovely floral wings, best thoughts, and silhouettes and script. And this is the one that I used for my Hawaii swap. I used this in addition to the butterfly basic stamp set. Phew. Yeah. I thought I was going to forget the name of that. And I think everything here is the same. We've got our little index here. I showed you the sprinkles of life. So, yeah, that's everything. Now, let me look through my stuff here and see what I wanted to cover. Okay, the bookmarks, the recruiting special, my in-color bundles. So I got all that just in case anybody had a question. Now, it's 8:15. Oh, Jason, you'll have to show me. Do you guys want me to make a project really quick, or do you want me to not? I know I have a couple more questions. Karen, you were asking me about getting, about binding my catalog. So I'll tell you, a lot of demonstrators actually take theirs to Kinko's or Office Max. They charge a very minimal price. I want to say like $5. I honestly don't leave my house very often, and when I do, I'm always desperate to get back. So I did not want to leave my catalog with anyone. So I did it myself. I do have the bind it all. The only hard part about it, I could film a video. The problem is that I have a big, huge industrial cutter, and I was able to just cut the very edge of my catalog completely off. And so then I just lined up the pages with the bind it all, and I got all the holes punched, and then I just put the coil on there. So, Karen, do you have the bind it all? The only reason I haven't filmed a video, honestly, is just because I don't know how to tell people how to cut their catalog, because I have that big old huge industrial cutter, and it might just be easier for a lot of people just to take it to Staples or Office Max or Office Depot. Let me know if you have more questions about that. Okay, so we're going to make a project. I'm going to use a Hostess stamp set. I hope I haven't missed any questions. I think there's been others on here. Okay, Karen, you do have the bind it all. Do you have a way of cutting your catalog? Because I know I was getting out an X-Acto knife and trying to cut. It wasn't working very good. What was happening was, it wouldn't cut straight. So, no, it's not a Carl cutter, unfortunately. The Carl cutter isn't thick enough. I tried sliding this in there because I have that too. But no, I have a really big, huge. Oh, it's so big. Every year I say I'm getting rid of that thing because it's in storage. Okay, so we're going to make a thank you card. And we're going to be using this image here. I'll try to make this really, really fast. Just because I know you guys have been here for over an hour now. Do the catalog in parts. I couldn't find a good way to cut it though at all. Like, oh, you mean actually pull it off the edge? Yeah. Oh my gosh, is it worthwhile? Absolutely, because watch this. This is so fabulous. Stampin' Up! Used to give us a spiral bound one when we would go to convention. But look, we can turn this puppy over just like that and it lies flat. So that, oh, it's so awesome to be able to lay your catalog flat like that. If you don't have it spiral bound, you can't. It's just, that other side just won't go anywhere. Okay, so I'm going to score this crumb cake cardstock at 5.5. It measures 11 by 4.25. And I should be using one of the new in colors, but I don't have all my supplies in yet, so I'm using crumb cake. And look, the reason I'm using that image is because it fits in a punch. Well, the pages will rip, yeah. And they, yeah, well, and it's not that they'll rip, it's just that they don't have that good clean edge. Like, if you look at the edge of this, it's all nice and precise. When you start ripping the pages out of the catalog, like, for example, if you look, this first page is still stuck to page one. Yeah. So, Lisa, I will be adding some of them, but I can safely say that it will not be until probably when school starts back, because Laura handles all of my shipping and everything, and her kids are on summer break. So, yeah, probably not till August, September. And then there's some that we can't sell yet, so I got to stop talking for a second. I just grabbed a handful of doilies because I came up with this idea today, and I didn't know if it was brilliant or if it was not. But at the time that I figured it out, I was like, oh, this is so awesome. So what I'm going to do is cut this doily in half. And the best way for me to make sure that I cut it exactly in half is actually fold it in half and create that. Oh, is somebody leaving? Bye. Good night. Cynthia, I have not posted anything about it yet because I want to make sure I get all my videos done. It's all going to be on Chicken Click. It's not going to be on Chicken Scratch. So I haven't fit because I want to make sure every video is done before I breathe a word of it. Although I did breathe a word of it today, didn't I? But that's just because, like, every time Laura comes into work, she's like, oh, these are so cute. I'm like, I know, I can't wait to show everybody. But I have to film the videos. So, okay, so here's my idea today that I came up with. Man, that does not look right. If that's because it's not. I think I have to get another piece of paper. In fact, I know I do. But I'll go ahead and show you this and then I'll get up real quick. Look how cute this is. If you cut the doily in half and then make them meet up like that. Isn't that neat? Susan, I have a link on my, on Chicken Scratch on how to join Chicken Click. You just click on the button. Yeah, if you want the link, you can email me, or if you go to my Chicken Scratch blog, it's right at the top. in the banner, or below the banner, you'll see the link. I got to get up really quick and get a piece of cardstock. I thought I had it. Maybe I dropped it. Nope. It was sitting on the trimmer still. Sorry about that. Oh, somebody else is leaving. Bye. Have a good night. Okay, let me move these really quick. So I'm going to cut this piece at 5 1/4 by 4. Okay, and then I'm going to emboss it. This is the last day for my Texture Boutique, although I've told everyone I am going to continue using it because it's just such an easy way to emboss. So I'm going to emboss this, what's it called? Stylish Stripes. And I'm looking for my, here we go. Stylish Stripes embossing folder. Oh, Office Depot and Office Max merged? Seriously? Wow. I wonder if that means we're going to have some stores close. Hi, Sue. How are you doing? Are you just getting here? Okay, so I have embossed this. Now, I'm going to try to stop talking really quick and get this card made. Although we have some people that are just now joining us. So, I've already gone through the catalog, but we are making a card now. And I've sponged the wrong side of the card. Oh, they won't cut it? Oh, Lisa, yeah, I answered that, I thought. Yeah, I answered it. Yes, Lisa, we're going to add the retired items, but not until August or September because I need my adhesive. The reason we're not going to add them until August or September is because Laura, her kids, my assistant, they're on summer break, and and she does all the shipping, and she takes care of the chick shop. I take care of Chick and Click and my blog, and she takes care of the chick shop and my Hostess Code Club, and okay, I gotta stop talking. I don't know what I'm doing. I got that far. Okay, so I embossed this with the Stylish Stripes embossing folder, and then I cut the doily in half, and I've added it onto the front here, which I love. Now I'm going to stamp the image. Hopefully, I knew I would. Oh well. I'm just so happy it fits right in that punch. Isn't that so pretty? I love the font too. Sponging. But there are some people that absolutely hate it. So, I go in spurts. Sometimes I sponge everything and then I stop. Okay, so isn't that so pretty? I still have a couple more things to add to it. These buttons are retiring. I think they're retiring. Let's make sure real quick before I say that. I'm pretty sure they are. They were in the Occasions catalog. And yes, they have. This is it. This is their final. It's called the Sweet Dreams. I've actually really liked this pack of buttons. I like the white ones. I like the hearts. The Lost Lagoon ones with the little stitching. But this little button right here, stinking cute. I got out some linen thread a couple minutes ago. I promise I'm going to look at your questions in a minute. I'm going to try to wrap up this card really quick. I'll scroll up and look at the questions. Yes, I'll post this card on my blog. And so for those of you that need to go ahead and leave, I will refilm the video tomorrow, a really quick 5-minute video, and post it. Because I know it's getting late, especially for those of you on Eastern time zone. I know. Well, Susan, I stamped this image last week in the watermelon wonder. I already told y'all I was going to struggle with that. Man, when you stamp it in a neutral color, it gives it a whole other look to it. A softer look. Okay, so there's my little button. Isn't that cute? And then, let's see. Do I have rhinestones? Oh, I know I was going to cut something. I'm going to cut a label out, a deco label, really quick. Mm-hmm. You know what? I'm not going to put my big shot in the station. I'm just going to cut it really quick out of the camera. Okay, let's see. That looks pretty good. See, I don't have... Oh, I'm going to call it done. Well, I'm going to get some rhinestones. I was thinking that if I had some ribbon, I mean, I've already done the linen thread on the button, so I could, let me put this back up here in front of you, so I could do that, but I've already used the linen thread with my button, and I really like the button, so I'm not going to use it again. I'm just going to get my dimensionals. I'm going to go ahead and add this image or this layer, and I'm going to call it done, I think. Okay. Could I gently ink the edges of the doilies? I could. I have before. But then if I... They kind of already look like they're... I'm going to pop this one up. I'm almost done. I'm not going to pop up that one because I want to be able to place the button. I think. I don't know. Let's see. We'll attach it and then we'll decide. Okay, so I can attach the button here at the edge, which, I don't know. I kind of like it right there. But if I put it there, then I need another rhinestone right here. Yeah, I like it. There's a couple things I could change, but you know what? I can make that another card. Plus, this little piece right here, unless you've already ordered it or unless you plan on ordering tonight, this little button's going to be gone because it's retiring. So, I think it's cute. Yeah, it's cute. It's an Angie card. Well, I thought about it earlier when I figured out I was trying to work on a project for Chicken Click, or no, Stamp Club Online, and I came up with this cutting the doily in half, and then I was like, oh, yeah, so part of it I already had in my head. Which stamp set is that? It is the one of the Hostess sets. And I gave you guys fair warning earlier that I was going to try to use Hostess sets a little bit more to encourage new members to join Stamp Club Online and Hostess Code Club. So this is a whole lot of lovely. I love this. I like this one too. I've used this. And this is the image that I used for my in-color bookmarks. I figured it fit really perfect in that space for the bookmarks. Okay, so an hour and a half. Are there any questions? Oh, my station is all messy. Thanks, Kim. I forgot to ask if we had any new people that had never been to a live stream. I should have asked that. Oh, and I am going to be doing an online workshop again this month. So it's going to be a little bit further in June. So you can watch for the dates of that. I haven't decided yet. It really depends on if we go to Tennessee or not. Yeah. Thanks, Susan. Who has to talk with me and teach to speak a little English? Oh. Thanks, Sue. It's cute. It's still missing something. There's something about it. Like, there needs to be something going across. Yeah, I don't know. Oh, Susan, Sue, just email me. Oh, you don't have a catalog?